But we have all congregated here as a group because we want to mark this week of drug awareness. We want to talk and reflect on the drug abuse in this country and elsewhere. Why is the issue of drug abuse important to us that we have to assemble here this morning? It is important to us because it has caused great devastation, not only to this country, but to the world at large. It has affected many Kenyans. It has affected many churches, and I believe my own church. So we have all a huge, huge problem that we can't run away from, that we need to address. Before I speak about the devastation the drug abuse has caused to the world and Kenya in particular, I want us to have the big picture. I want us to have the big picture that God created man for his own glory. God created man not to fall into sin. He created man for a loving companionship for eternity. But for inexplicable reasons, Satan fell into sin. He sought supremacy over Christ. And when eventually he was overthrown, he caused man to sin. And as a result of that sin, man got separated from Christ. Since that time, there is a great controversy. Controversy between Satan and Christ over the soul of man. Christ is pleading to all of us to come to him so that we can be saved from sin. Satan wants to take control of us. And because of God's nature, God cannot use force. God cannot use lies. But those are the weapons the devil is using. And if you look around, you will see that he is actually winning the world because he can use trickery, which our Lord cannot use. Satan has caused calamities in the world. The incurable diseases, the conflict and war. And as a result, we are like warring against each other. Our news media are awash with stories of the kind of things that are going on. In the last 2 weeks, we have been reading about killings in Matungu in Western province. You can't understand why some people would go to a home and literally kill the entire family. That's why I said that we appear to be warring with each other and killing ourselves. All these are efforts of the devil to make sure that we are drawn away from the saving grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Back to the drugs. For the love of money, the drug barons all over are making sure that drugs are available to our children especially. They don't care a damn the damage they are causing. They don't care a damn the devastations they are causing to the young people who they are targeting particularly, especially at the very young age. Ladies and gentlemen, as a result of those efforts, alcohol and drug abuse is one of the greatest social challenges confronting us today. Its biting effect is felt in all parts of our country. But what do we mean by drugs? What do we mean by the phrase drug abuse? The term drug has two different meanings depending on the context. The United Nations Office on Drug and Crime tells us that there are two broad meanings of the term drug. In medicine, it refers to any substance with curative properties. In other words, it can be used to enhance the physical and the mental welfare of a person. The more common usage of the term, however, is in reference to psychoactive drugs, and more specifically, illicit or prescribed drugs. Our focus this afternoon is on the second meaning. Drug abuse, the UNODC adds, refers to the harmful and hazardous use of psychoactive substances, including alcohol and illicit drugs. A key characteristic of the drug is substance abuse is a strong and uncontrollable desire to continue taking the drug, and the terrible withdrawal symptoms when one ceases to use the drug. Abuse of drugs is a catastrophic problem. Just move. Abuse of drugs is a catastrophic problem of global proportions. UNODC publishes an annual World Drug Report, which documents and reports the scourge of drug abuse. According to the 2018 report, about 275 million people worldwide, which is roughly about 5.6% of the global population,